Yeah, hi everyone. Madrid calling. We are printing a series of prints for Jørgen Haugen Sørensen, and I'm going to take you through the process a little bit so you can see each step of what we're actually doing. So we're talking about six prints in this last format, as you can see here. These are not the final prints, they are state proofs. And as you can see here, we have Elena preparing the backgrounds, which are made directly onto an acetate plate in a technique that's called monotype. It's applying this very thin, extremely thin layer of ink, turpentine, with a brush, but that's the only time that we actually apply the brush. From then on, it's the ink itself that just deposits and run over the surface. And this way it leaves a cloudy, semi-uniform layer of ink. Okay, so the ink has been applied onto the acetate, and now she's moving the ink, this liquid ink, from side to side to erase a little bit the brush strokes. And from then on, the ink will take its own course and will slowly ease out onto the surface. And the result, as you will see later, will become this, as I said before, this sort of foggy, non-descriptive background. Okay, another step in the first step in the process is the paper. It's already been cut, evidently. We've soaked it in water. We did this yesterday, and this morning we've taken it through the press just once, even before we start printing it, because the paper can expand up to 2 centimeters in the water, and we need to get it stretched out beforehand, so we won't have a problem when we are registering the print. Okay, while Elena is doing the part of the monotype, Usama is now preparing the plates. Each individual print is printed from two plates, left and right. Here's the other one. And they will be inked in a much more solid color, but it's the same color, so to speak, than the monotype that we've used.
Yeah, as you have seen in previous emails, it's all a matter of applying ink and then taking the ink, the excess ink down of the plate. But in this case, we are also aiming to clean everything very, very much. Borders of the plates, the white surfaces, so that no accidents happen in the print. Okay, while Usama is printing or inking the plates, we're waiting for the turpentine to evaporate from the surface. It's coming together nicely. It's controllable up to a certain point, which is the nice thing about it. Some accidents might happen in the sense that dust and bits of ink will remain in the surface. This is something we've decided not to control too much because it gives the background a more spontaneous look. Okay, so this is almost ready. And what Elena is doing now is just cleaning the edges of the plate so we don't have any accumulation of ink in that area. Both of the plates have also been inked now and are ready to go. And Usama is also cleaning the edges so that we have, you know, perfectly clean edges. This has also something to do with the fact that the two plates will come together in the center, and that will leave a white line here, which we then have a conservator who will come in and retouch once the pieces have been printed.
turn the paper. Print side down. And then we place it in the press. Prepared for the print.
So this looks a little strange, but we have to roll the paper up before we put the monotype plate down. And we print it this way also, unrolling the paper as it goes through the press. And this we do in order to avoid, I think that's called push marks, which is an accident that happens when the paper hits the surface of the monotype for too long before it goes through the press.
The less surface, the less contact the paper has with the surface before it actually prints, the better in this particular case.
Cortei.
And there you have it.
Yeah, here's the final print, as you've just seen it come off the press. And as you can see, the background fits in very nicely with the brush strokes. We cleaned the heads a little bit, as Jorgen wanted it. And that goes out, that happens in throughout the series. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye.